video we'll discuss about ameloblastoma management. Basically, there are two varieties of managing techniques. The first one is conservative treatment and second one is radical resection. These are two philosophies to manage the ameloblastoma, right? Conservative treatment, we include enucleation plus or minus curettage. That means enucleation only or with the adding of curettage, right? Then we have cryotherapy, cauterization. In cauterization, we can use electrocoagulation or carnized solution and excisional biopsies. These are the options available in conservative treatment. Then coming to the radical resection, we may go for marginal resection or en bloc resection and segmental resection or hemimandibulectomy plus or minus disarticulation and maxillectomy. These are the options available in radical resection. So basically, if you see the ameloblastoma, it could be broadly, it could be multicystic ameloblastoma or unicystic ameloblastoma or peripheral ameloblastoma. In this, multicystic or solid ameloblastomas are aggressive one, right? They should be generally treated by radical resection. And the unicystic ameloblastomas, in that we have three types, right? Luminal and intraluminal ameloblastomas, unicystic ameloblastomas are somewhat less aggressive. That means they lack the capacity of invasiveness, right, to invade the surrounding bone. So they can be treated by conservative treatment. But the disadvantages of conservative treatment is high rate of recurrence. So we have the indications for conservative treatment: unicystic ameloblastomas, as I said, luminal and intraluminal ameloblastomas, unicystic ameloblastomas, the mural unicystic ameloblastomas, again they have invasiveness and aggressive. They should be treated by radical resection, right? And peripheral ameloblastomas can be treated by excisional biopsy or other conservative treatment, right? And small ameloblastomas, that is ameloblastomas involving only central part, that is medullary portion, not much expansion of cortical plates, that is small lesions, you can go for conservative treatment. But remember, there is always risk of high recurrence after conservative treatment. These are the indications for conservative treatment. In radical resection, as I told, multicystic or solid ameloblastomas or mural unicystic ameloblastomas or giant ameloblastomas. That is very large lesions should be treated by radical resection. These are the indications, right? Now we'll see about the conservative treatment modalities. Enucleation. Enucleation is nothing but the complete removal of the ameloblastic lining, right? That is ameloblastic tumor context is completely removed. If you take this diagram, right, if there is ameloblastoma involved in this region, right, see, this is the ameloblastoma, say this is the ameloblastoma involving second molar, first molar and second premolar, right? There is not much expansion of the cortical plates. In those cases, in enucleation, what we'll do, we'll remove the teeth, right? First, we'll remove the teeth. After that, we'll remove the complete lining of the complete ameloblastic contents and complete lining of the ameloblastoma, right? This is the simple enucleation, right? Right. I have removed teeth and we have removed the complete lining and contents of the ameloblastoma. This is enucleation, simplest form of treatment, right? If we add curettage, then after this procedure, after enucleation, we have to take a curette and we have to scrape the walls. I have removed the teeth and complete lining and complete ameloblastic contents. That is simplest enucleation. After that, if you add the curettage, that means you have to take the curette and this is the bony walls of, after removing the ameloblastoma, we have to take a curette and we have to scrape these walls with that curette, we have to scrape these walls with that curette, so that 1 to 2 mm of the bone is removed. That is called as curettage. Right? Then coming to the cryotherapy. Cryotherapy, electrocoagulation and carnized solution, these are almost same. Right? First we have to remove the teeth, then lining is removed. Right? After that, if you are using the cryotherapy, we have to use a probe, liquid nitrogen, which applies minus 62 degree centigrade to bone walls. We have to take that cryotherapy probe and we have to apply it on the these bony walls. So due to the extreme cold, the surrounding tissue, surrounding some bone cells also, and it could be the invaded ameloblastic cells, they will die. Right? That will lead to a better therapy. So you can't use these cryotherapy, electrocoagulation and carnized solution as an individual treatment, that is primary treatment. Better, they should be used along with the surgery. They should be used along with the surgery to improve the treatment. If you are using electrocoagulation, that is electrocautery, again you have to take the electrocautery and apply it on the bony walls. The mechanism is same. The necrosis, they will produce necrosis and death of ameloblastic cells. Right? Then in carnized solution is somewhat important question. It could be asked as a short answer or very short answer. So the first composition, it contains 60% ethanol, and after that it contains 30% chloroform and glacial acetic acid also, and 1 gram of ferric chloride. So this is the composition, and this solution should be prepared freshly at the time of surgery only. After preparing, we have to take a gauze and dip that gauze in that solution. Okay, and after that we have to take that gauze and apply here. Apply in this defect area. This is the gauze, right? And this gauze should be applied for at least 3 to 5 minutes. Again the same, this is the chemical cauterization. It produces necrosis of surrounding bony margins, thereby decreasing the chances of recurrence rate. Right? Then excisional biopsy especially indicated in cases of peripheral ameloblastoma, which are less than 2 cm in size. In those cases, we will excise complete ameloblastic, that soft tissue growth, that is simplest excisional biopsy. So these are all about the conservative treatment. So the main disadvantage of conservative treatment is the high rate of recurrence, almost about 90%. So you have to selectively do the treatment in selected cases. This is not indicated for everything. Then coming to the radical resection. In radical resection, we have marginal resection or en bloc resection. This is important question, can be asked as 4 mark question. That is separate short answer. So in marginal resection, en bloc resection, will remove the ameloblastoma along with some amount of normal bone. Right? You can see in this diagram, we have removed, this is the removed part of the mandible. We have removed first molar, first premolar, second premolar and first molar. Ameloblastoma involving that region. We have prepared almost a box shaped osteotomy and we removed that. So this is with preserving lower part of the mandible. Right? That is the main difference between the marginal resection and segmental resection. Segmental resection will remove complete lower border of the mandible also. That means in this case, this is the marginal resection, and if I remove this lower border also, that means the diagram will be like this. Right? This is the segmental resection. So after resection, we have to go for reconstruction. This could be with the reconstruction plate in old age patients, or if the patient is young, then you can go for the bone grafts also. It could be the vascularized bone graft or non-vascularized bone graft, right? After doing this, we'll fix a reconstruction plate like this. Three screws on one side and three screws on another side. This is primary reconstruction with the reconstruction plate, right? Then hemimandibulectomy plus or minus disarticulation. That is removal of complete half side of the mandible. Without a disarticulation means removing half side of the mandible without condyle. You can see in this diagram, right? If you leave the condyle, prepare an osteotomy here, and this is the complete removal of coronoid process along with the ramus, angle, and half side of the mandible. If you remove like this, this is called as hemimandibulectomy without disarticulation. That means we are preserving condyle. With disarticulation means we'll remove condyle also. That means complete half side of the mandible is removed. Okay, then maxillectomy. Maxillectomy, there are various types of maxillectomy, we'll discuss later. Maxillectomy is indicated in cases of ameloblastoma involving the maxilla. Right, this is about radical section and the surgical approach. That means how will you take the incision. There are three types of surgical approach you can use. Intraoral and intraoral plus lip split, or extraoral submandibular incision. These are the three types of surgical approaches you can use to expose the tumor region. In intraoral exposure, if the tumor is, intraoral exposure is indicated in cases of small lesion which can be accessed intraorally. In this case, you have to take the clavicular incisions, right? That means incisions are given around the necks of the teeth. Depending on how much access you want, the first incision is taken around the neck of the teeth. Depending on the situation, you can take the releasing incision also. After that, we have to elevate the flap, right? Elevate the flap and we can remove the involved area. So in marginal resection, you can go for preferably this intraoral approach. Okay, this is about intraoral approach. In some cases, when the tumor is extensive, intraoral approach you can't go, or you intraoral approach cannot provide complete access. In those cases, you can go for lip split. You can see in this diagram, this is a lip split. Lip split is nothing but lower lip is split in midline like this. This is the upper lip and this is the lower lip. So we have to split the lower lip in midline like this, and then preparing a step and complete. So this incision is extended till the lower border of the mandible. You can see in this diagram, after lip splitting, after elevation of the flap, this is the lower lip retracted inferiorly, and this is the another side of the lip. Okay, and this is the amount of exposure you are going to get. Complete half of the mandible can be exposed by this approach. Right? So, if the tumor is located here, then you can go for marginal resection or extraoral resection, or you can go for the hemimandibulectomy also by this approach. After that, you have to close the flap. Right? This is about lip split incision. And extraoral incision, submandibular incision is not, you know that. Again, based on the tumor involvement, you have to take the incision in the submandibular region 2 cm below and parallel to the lower border of the mandible. This is the lower border of the mandible, so we have to take the incision like this. And after that, you have to elevate and you can remove the tumor. And you can do the hemimandibulectomy by this submandibular incision also, right? This is about the approaches. There are three approaches. The main principle in radical resection is you have to maintain a margin of 1 to 1.5 centimeter. That is the most important principle. Whether we are going for marginal resection or segmental resection, in those cases, you have to maintain or you have to include normal bone of 1 to 1.5 centimeter in your tumor resection. That is the most important thing. And whether you are going for, whether you have to go for this marginal resection or segmental resection, that depends on the tumor size or tumor involvement of bone. If the inferior border of the mandible is involved, then you have to go for segmental resection. That is how you have to select the which procedure you have to go for. Okay, so after resection, you can go for primary reconstruction of the segments with a reconstruction plate, or you can go for the bone grafting also, vascularized or non-vascularized bone grafts can also be used, right? And after that, you can give the dental processes also with the replacement of the teeth. And we'll discuss this maxillectomy in another video. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel, and watch the maxillectomy video also, because it is the treatment for ameloblastomas involving the maxilla.